Hello, dear children. How are you all? Today we are meeting after the holidays, right? So hope you are doing well. Today in this first class, we are going to learn about adjective from lesson number 8. So let's start. Now first, definition of adjective. An adjective is a word used to add something to the meaning of a noun, in bracket, person, place, animal, or thing, or a pronoun. Now why I have written in bracket person, place, animal, or thing? Because noun is the name of a person, place, animal, or thing, right? Or a pronoun. So adjective is a word used to add something to the meaning of a noun. Now, for example, Ram is a kind man. The word which is in bold, kind, is written there before man. Instead of that, we could have written Ram is a man. The sentence is correct here, but we are adding something to the noun. Who is noun here? Ram. We are adding something to the noun to make it more meaningful. What is that word? Kind. Ram is a kind man. If you write Ram is a man, that is correct, but we don't have any adjective in that sentence. So to add meaning or to add an adjective, what you have to write? You have to write something so that the noun becomes more meaningful or the pronoun becomes more meaningful. Ram is a kind man. Next example, the old man is wearing a black shirt. Now which words are highlighted here? Old and black. You can see the old man is wearing a black shirt. If you write by removing old and black, then also the sentence is correct. The man is wearing a shirt. I am not using old and black. Simply I am using the man is wearing a shirt. This sentence is correct. But we are adding something. What we have added here? That is old and black. The old man is wearing a black shirt. Old is an adjective and black is also an adjective. Number 3. The thin man is carrying a huge box. The thin man is carrying a huge box. Huge. These two are also adjective. If you write the man is carrying a box, that is also correct, but we will not have adjective at that time. Understood? So what is the definition of adjective? An adjective is a word used to add something to the meaning of a noun or a pronoun. Next, kinds of adjectives. How many kinds of adjectives are there? There are 4 kinds of adjectives. Number 1, adjective of quality, adjective of quantity, adjective of number, and demonstrative adjectives. How many kinds of adjectives are there? There are 4 kinds, and these are the names. All right. Now, definitions of adjective of quality. It tells us about the size, shape, color, or particular quality of a noun or a pronoun. You know what is size? Yes, big, small, all these are large, huge, all these are size. Shape like round, square, rectangle. rectangle, triangle, all these are shape. Color, blue, red, green, yellow. And quality, like honesty, kindness, all these are quality, right? So, adjective of quality tells us about the size, always remember, size, shape, color, or particular quality of a noun or a pronoun. For example, he is an honest man. Honest is a quality. Number two, it is a large box. Large is highlighted. And what is large? It's a size. Okay. Number three, Tom is wearing a blue shirt. Color. And number four, marbles are round. Shape. So, adjective of quality describes about the size, shape, color, or particular quality. Next is adjectives of quantity. It tells us how much of something is there. They do not show the exact number. For example, some children reached early. Number two, all the apples were rotten. Some, how much? Now, if I say some, then you cannot tell the exact number. If I say all, you cannot say the exact number. If I say much, you cannot say the exact number. It is just like we are talking about weight. If I say, give me some rice, that's some. How will you count that sound? It is not countable, it is uncountable. When you are identifying adjective of quality, you will always find such words like some, all, enough, much. These words tells us that the things are uncountable. Understood? You cannot count some. Can you count enough? I have enough water to drink. That word enough. Can you count water like 1, 2, 3, 4? No, you cannot count. So, in adjective of quantity, always remember adjectives of quantity is uncountable. Okay? It tells us how much of something is there. They do not show the exact number. You cannot say 2 children or 3 children. When we say some children, many children, then these words indicates quantity. Understood? Next is adjective of number. It tells us the number or position of people, animal, or things. For example, I have 5 close friends. And number 2, Sarah bought 3 mangoes and 3 apples, 2 apples. The adjective of number is countable. Here, adjective of quantity we have, that is uncountable. And adjective of number is countable. By the example only we can understand that I have 5 close friends. 5 is countable, right? If I say I have some close friends, then that sum will be uncountable. Here it is, here the exact number is given, that is 5. I have 5 close friends. Number 2, Sarah bought 3 mangoes. Now that 3. 1, 2, 3. 3 mangoes are countable. And 2 apples. 2. The word 2 is also countable. So, in adjective of number, we can tell what is the exact number of people, animal, or thing. Like 5 people, 10 people, 3 animals, 2 fans, 3 pencils, 10 baskets. All these are countable. The last one is demonstrative adjective. Demonstrative adjective which point out people are called demonstrative adjectives. For example, this is quite interesting. That parrot has beautiful green feathers. These dresses are big for me. And the last one, those boys are very noisy. adjective which pointer? When we say these, we point our fingers. Yes or no? When you are keeping something near you, near your desk or a table or in the bed, which is near to you, you say these. This book is quite interesting. This is my pen. This is my copy. And something, if you are going to point out which is very far or something little bit far, you will say that. This is used for near object. T-H-I-S is used to indicate something that is which is near, and that is used to indicate something which is far. Now that parrot has beautiful green flowers. You are going to point your finger and say that. Yes or no? Number three. These dresses are big for me. Now T-H-E-S-E. This is the plural form of this. T-H-I-S. Understood? Now these dresses are big for me. These something, some dresses are lying near to you. Okay, and you are pointing that these dresses are big for me. That means there is not only one dress, but maybe 3 to 4 to 5 dresses. But this is near to you. T-H-I-S, this, and T-H-E-S-E, this is used to point the objects which are near to you or close to you. And that and those is used to indicate the objects which are far away. Those boys are very noisy. That means those boys are standing maybe very far, or not so very far, but little bit far. So you are pointing that those boys are very noisy. These and these are used for objects which are close by, and that and those are used for objects which are far away. Alright, so the explanation of lesson number 8 is completed here. The exercises part we will do in the next class. Till then, you revise the definitions and look at the examples and try to revise the lesson. Thank you.